The topic of secondary AML is a complex one, and one that it challenges hematologists every day. Secondary AML is a difficult definition because it doesn't really exist in the WHO. So we generally consider it a term that encompasses a lot of different types of AML, but mostly related to AML that evolves from prior hematologic disorders such as MDS or myeloproliferative neoplasm and therapy-related AML. So these different types of AML are lumped into one category known as secondary AML, but the common theme is that they're very difficult to treat and they tend to be resistant to most forms of chemotherapy. For example, we've learned through the years that induction chemotherapy approaches for secondary AML are not very successful. And although some patients do achieve remission and can be successfully transplanted, most patients unfortunately will not respond to initial therapy and ultimately die of their disease. And we've learned quite a bit about the biology of secondary AML over the years, really now understanding it as a disease of clonal evolution. So many patients with secondary AML have a pre-existing clone, a clonal hematopoiesis as we know it, that predates the development of the leukemia, but persists during the time frame in which a person has leukemia by virtue of the fact that secondary or subsequent mutational events occur that then drive the disease into a more aggressive and proliferative phase. So now people are looking at targeting these particular pathways that are affected by these mutations as a way to maybe bypass the traditional therapeutic resistance in secondary AML. Some of the newer therapies that are being tested in secondary AML or have been studied in AML include a drug that I've worked with known as Vyxeos or CPX351, which is a combined liposomal product of daunorubicin and cytarabine in a fixed molar ratio that delivers both drugs to the leukemic cell at a higher level of efficiency. And a phase 3 study that we did showed improved outcomes in terms of survival compared to 7+3 induction treated patients who had secondary AML. So the landscape is changing a little bit with the introduction of Vyxeos for patients with secondary AML by virtue of the fact that that drug did show an improved survival effect compared to standard induction therapy. But there's still a lot of challenges remaining, and to date not too many other drugs have shown great efficacy in secondary AML. Some of the drugs that have been tested include drugs such as a modified hypomethylating agents and newer generation hypomethylating agents, which are showing some degree of activity, but in general are still limited in their overall efficacy. So I think that the future for secondary AML will depend upon the development of novel therapeutics that really target the primary and secondary molecular lesions that are associated with secondary AML, and also to target other pathways that may be important, such as the methylation pathways that are felt to be upregulated in secondary AML, and even immune checkpoint pathways, which may also be upregulated in secondary AML, that could be potentially targeted by novel therapies.